I quit my full-time iOS dev job, and now I'm back to being a full-time iOS dev, YouTuber, content creator, and wannabe indie dev. So what the hell happened? Why did I quit? What am I gonna work on moving forward? Like, what does that mean for this channel? So a quick recap for those that are new here. I was doing YouTube as my full-time job from 2019 to 2024. And, you know, working by yourself kind of gets lonely, work from home, got boring, got a little stale, and I wanted to work on an exciting new project. So I put out this tweet, and very quickly, I was hired by Podcast AI to build their podcasting app. And the project was great. It was exactly what I was looking for. It had the AI component to it. There was also a Vision OS app in the works. The team was great, smart. They had some traction already. Like, it was good. However, life happened, so to speak, and my life circumstances changed. So it wasn't just me single in my one bedroom apartment anymore. There's a family involved now. I'm a homeowner, got this puppy. And to make a long story short, I was just spread way too thin. Again, the full-time job, trying to keep the YouTube business afloat. Like, I knew it wasn't gonna thrive, but I didn't want it to die. And like, it was dying. And that's important because this YouTube channel is like my freedom, my optionality, right? I don't have to have a job as long as I have this YouTube channel. Well, as I'm seeing that die, you know, I start to worry a little bit, like, oh man, am I gonna be like stuck in a job? So I'm trying to keep the YouTube channel afloat. Again, being a homeowner, like, is no joke. I underestimated that. And again, this damn puppy, I love the dude, but hey, he's a lot of work. So yeah, spread way too thin. I was dropping so many balls. I felt like I was failing my relationship, my work, my YouTube business, just failing everywhere. So I needed to get my time back to kind of regain my sanity. Because when you're giving your full workday to a full-time employer, as I'm sure many of you know, there's not a lot of time in the day for all that other stuff. And that also made me realize, like, just how good I had it when I was doing full-time YouTube previously. Like, complete control over my time. I could do what I want when I wanted. I could squeeze things in. I could adjust the schedule. Like, I really took for granted how good I had it. So getting my time back so I can manage my relationships, the house, the puppy, all my adult responsibilities was the main reason for leaving Podcast AI. And there are some secondary reasons why I left Podcast AI, aside from getting my time back. One, I took a pay cut to go there because I wanted to be on that fun, exciting team. I started to feel the effects of the pay cut after a while. And when you're working for a salary, like, no matter how good you do, no matter how good your ideas are, you make your salary. Sure, you can get a raise. What are you gonna get, a 10% raise, 20% raise? But at the end of the day, when you're building a business like the YouTube stuff, especially on the internet, where like the scale is like infinite, there's so much leverage on my work and time. And if my ideas are good, I execute them well, I build great products, I make great videos, my income potential is endless, right? So I guess I underestimated the effects of having that ceiling of a salary, knowing that like I can't make more than this. That was also starting to affect me too. And then of course, I was working with AI all year and I got to really dive in and witness the superpowers it gives you firsthand. And then I started thinking like, yes, this makes me a way better, more effective programmer, but I started to think about how I could apply this to the YouTube business and the content creation as well. And I was like, man, why am I giving this superpowered version of Sean to someone else? Like, I need to be using this superpower for me and my business. Cause it's never been a better time to be a indie app developer, solopreneur, content creator, whatever you wanna call it, right? With AI, like, this is like the golden age. And I've already done the hard part where I've built the audience. So yeah, when you add all that up, it just didn't make sense to be at that job anymore. So here I am, back to being full-time content creation and indie dev. So what am I gonna work on moving forward? Now, I've said this before, but my ideal work situation, like the dream, if you will, is to earn my living, support my lifestyle straight from just my indie apps, like apps on the app store. The money from that is how I earn my living. And then YouTube business is kind of like a side thing. That's ideal. We're not there, obviously. YouTube is 100% of my income. I mean, CreatorView makes about $250 MRR. You can't really live off that. I mean, it's made about $6,000 over the 3 years that it's been live. But again, $2,000 a year, not gonna make a living off of that. So how I earn my living as an indie content creator is through my YouTube channel with the courses I sell and then sponsorships. So that's 100% of the pie right now. But what I'm gonna work towards is the indie app portfolio, because I got a couple other app ideas I wanna pump out, that piece of the pie to slowly start growing and getting bigger and bigger and bigger, right? Maybe after the first year, it's 5 to 10% of my income. After year two, maybe it's like 20 to 30% of my income, and you see where this is going. After 3 to 4 years, it has eclipsed YouTube as my main income source, and now we're living the dream, if you will, that I want for myself. But it's tricky because I can't go all in on the apps, right? My life has changed, like all the things I mentioned. So I do have a certain amount of income I have to make. So it's gonna be a tricky balance, you know, working on the YouTube business, putting out courses, making videos to make enough money to, you know, pay the bills and not have to worry about money. But then also, you know, on the side, start dedicating time to the indie apps to start growing that piece of the pie. Now, what does this mean for the channel? Well, to put it simply, you're gonna get more content. I'm not gonna make any grandiose promises, but right now I do 2 videos a month because I'm contractually obligated by Squarespace to do those videos, but you're gonna get more content. I'm gonna shoot for 3 videos a week, but I'm not promising that. Don't hold me to that. But Swift News is gonna return to a weekly show. Those that have been subscribed to the channel for a while know that Swift News used to be weekly, then it went monthly. We're going back to weekly, and along with that, I'm launching a Swift News newsletter. Because it kind of makes sense, right? I've already done the work of gathering the articles. I've already formulated my thoughts on those articles. Why not have a newsletter as well? However, I am going to work to make that unique and interesting and not just links, because, right, I'm sure you subscribe to a bunch of newsletters and they all kind of share the same links. So I want to add my own spin on it to make it unique, to make it worthy of subscribing to. And I'm working on a Swift concurrency course that will hopefully be out in a few months. And lastly, I'm going to continue this vlog on the indie app pie, growing from 0% to hopefully over 50% over the next couple of years. I'll probably update once a month with, you know, the new features I'm building, maybe a new app I'm building, share some numbers, you know, what percentage of that pie we're up to. Maybe it's 1%, 3%, 5%, hopefully. So yeah, I'll share that journey again, probably about once a month. So that's it. I'm back to being full-time YouTube and working on the indie dev career. I'm fucking pumped.